if you have anybody that has wounds on their hands, on the feet, on any part of the body, if that wound has been taking time to heal, you need just one ingredient that will help you. My beauties, how are you guys doing? Welcome back to my channel. I am so excited today because I have a good tip for you that will help you if you have anybody that has wounds on their hands, on the feet, on any part of the body. If that wound has been taking time to heal, you need just one ingredient that will help you. And guys, what you need is sugar. Your normal sugar. This is white sugar. If you use brown sugar, it's also very fine, but it has to be sugar. Guys, sugar works very well for healing wounds. I know there are times that maybe you bruise your skin, it might be a burn, it might be anything basically, guys. But please, caveat or a disclaimer, kindly visit the hospital if you need to. If you've been going to the hospital for your dressing, if you've been going to the hospital to take care of it, please by all means still go. I'm just offering like a first aid that you can do from the comfort of your home, which will help you. You might think, why would I want to put sugar on my body? Well, it works really well. Sugar helps to like absorb the moisture on the wound. Anytime you have a wound and it has a lot of moisture, it takes time to dry, it takes time for it to heal. And sugar like overnight draws out all that moisture. It's like kind of like sucks it dry. It has like properties, antibacterial properties that help to like feed on the host, which is that wound, and to like suck everything dry. Like, so what you do is, if you have a wound, a swelling, whatever it is, like an open wound in this case, it usually works for open wounds, just take a little bit of the sugar. I don't have any wound on me, like, so I can't like display it, but this is what I know. I know some people ask me that, okay, you don't have this, why are you talking about this? And I always say it, if you go to the hospital, your doctor does not need to go through that sickness you're going through in court. Or why do we trust our doctors? They don't go through those things. A doctor that is taking care of a pregnant woman has never been pregnant. But if you've researched about it and you've learned about it, you know the right things to prescribe. And that is what I am doing in this case as well, because I get tons of comments and like people asking me that, okay, you've not done this, why are you talking about this? To be fair, I have had my fair share of things that I talk about on this channel, but it mustn't be every single thing. In the middle of me looking for solutions for something, I stumble on something else, and I think it is nice for me to bring it on board here to share. And it gladdens my heart when I tell people and they come back to me that, oh, this thing really worked for them. We don't need to hoard knowledge, we don't need to hoard information. When I research, when I even get from people, I like to come on board here to share, and I like tap people's like knowledge everywhere. I go around and I ask them, okay, what does this do, how does this work, and I see the benefits and I see like testimonials of it working for other people. So guys, before I bring anything here, it has been tested, it has worked. And so that's the same thing for sugar working for wounds. So it works for wounds very well. Just sprinkle a little bit. You don't need to add too much, just a little bit. Just sprinkle it on top of the wound and you can leave it there like that. You can still go about your normal dressing, you can still do your normal thing that you do to the wound. And but what is going to help you do is to like draw the moisture so that that wound will heal properly and it will heal very fast. I know how annoying it is for you to be carrying on something that you don't want on your body. And another thing here, let me just give you a bonus tip. If you don't want the wound to turn into a scar, this is something that my mother did for me right from when I was a child. You know, as children, you would definitely hurt yourself, you cut yourself, you do that. I even had one scar here, something like that. I burnt myself while ironing some days ago. So what she tells me is that while that wound is healing, when it has gone past the first stage of it being very fresh, while it's still like healing, before it gets healed totally, while it is drying, start applying honey. Honey like helps it to like, there will be no scar. Except it's like a very deep wound or a deep cut, like a 10-degree burn. That one is something you have to like leave to the mercy of the real professionals, like the skin grafting professionals and all those people that do all those kind of things. But for like tiny wounds, minor bruises that can turn to a scar later on, you don't want that. While it is healing, let's say it is like 70% healed, yes, start applying honey, just honey, your natural honey. Goodness, guys, you won't have any scar. I have tried it, this one I have tried it, and it works for me every single time. I will try it for my kids as well when I see that they've cut themselves or they like accidentally bumped into something or they fell. Instead of you having scar everywhere on your body, if not, there are some that may be inevitable, but rather than you having scars everywhere, it's not a tattoo. I'll just take some honey, apply, I keep on applying. Morning, afternoon, night, or let's say morning and in the evening, and before you know what is happening, it will heal on its own, heal very well, heal nicely with no scar. So guys, that's my tip for you today. If you think this video did any benefit to you, please thumbs up. I will appreciate it a lot. And also share, because you don't know who will need this bit of information. If you've not subscribed, kindly subscribe for more videos like this, and I'll see you in subsequent ones. Stay beautiful, stay healthy, stay safe, and don't hurt yourself. Bye.